Now I'll be discussing about the conjunction operation. So consider that there are two proposition P and Q. So let us say there are two proposition P and Q. So the conjunction of P and Q is denoted by this symbol, that is P. First we write the proposition P and then the symbol for logical AND, or you can say conjunction, and Q. How do we read this? We read it as P and Q. So the conjunction P and Q is true only when both P and Q are true, otherwise it is false. So this will become clear after seeing the truth table of this conjunction operator, right? So if you observe here, this is the proposition P and this is the proposition Q, and here the possible values of P and Q are taken. So when your P and Q both are true, only in that case the P conjunction Q is true. For rest other cases, if any one input is false, the result is also going to be false. So this is the truth table for your P and Q. Okay, so P and Q is true if and only if both the values of P and Q are true, otherwise the result is going to be false. Clear? So by this truth table, I hope this statement which is written here simply is clear now. Okay, so this was the details about the conjunction operation. Now let's look at an example. So if you consider this one, that find the conjunction of the proposition P and Q, where P is representing this sentence, that is, your Rebecca's PC has more than 16 GB free hard drive space, and Q is another proposition. Let us say the processor in Rebecca's PC runs faster than 1 GHz. So we have a proposition P and we have this proposition, that is processor 1. This statement is represented by Q. So as I've already said that propositional variables are very handy in order to represent statements like this. So the conjunction of this proposition P and Q can be written like this. And how can we read this? We can read this as Rebecca's PC has more than 16 GB free hard drive space, and we are using this English word here AND. Okay, if you observe here, we are using the English word here AND. And the processor in Rebecca's PC runs faster than 1 GHz. So simply we have written this statement P and Q in English. That's it. So this conjunction can also be expressed in a more simpler fashion, that is, Rebecca's PC has more than 16 GB hard drive space, comma, and its processor runs faster than 1 GHz. This is one other way of writing the same thing, right? So this statement, this is a propositional statement. And which kind of propositional statement? This is a compound proposition. Why? Because it is joined by logical operator, that is your conjunction. So whenever more than one propositions are involved along with your logical operators, so in that case we call compound proposition, right? So in the previous video I have talked about compound proposition. So this is one such example of your compound proposition. So this P and Q are your atomic propositions. So we combine atomic propositions together to form compound proposition. So this is just a picture in order to represent Rebecca and her PC. Okay, so just imagination. Anyways, so this is your compound proposition, and this P and Q itself are atomic proposition, or you can say simple proposition. Okay, so this was all about your conjunction operation and the denotation and how do we read it. Now there is an important part here that you should be focusing on. The point is that in mathematical logic, the word but is sometimes used instead of AND. So if you observe this statement here, the sun is shining but it is raining. So in English language there is a subtle difference between the word but and, right? So this word and this but word, there is a subtle difference in the natural language, that is the natural English language. But in logic, please remember, we use this but word and this word and. Okay, we are using these two words in order to denote this conjunction actually. So this is an important point that you should keep in mind. So in logic, but and this word and are used interchangeably, right? And this is the statement example that I have written here. The sun is shining but it's raining. So let us say the sun is shining is the statement P. So this much, okay, let me mark it in red color. So if you see this statement, this I'm representing it by the variable, proportional variable p, and this it is raining, this sentence I'm representing by the variable q. So in order to represent this using the conjunction, we write p and q, right? So although it is read as p and q, but you can also use this word but. In place of this word but, you can use this symbol here, p and q, right? So please remember that this word but and this and can be used interchangeably in logic. So in logic they have same meaning, but in natural language there is a subtle difference between them, and you know that very well, and we will not be concerned about that particular part. Okay, so I hope the logical operator, this conjunction is clear, the denotation and the truth table as well as the example. Okay.